Hi everyone, welcome to this PDF tutorial demonstrating how to include watermarks and bookmarks to a PDF document using the Syncfusion .NET PDF Library. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add text and image watermarks and remove watermarks from a PDF file. I will also show how to add, insert, modify, and remove bookmarks from a PDF document. First, I open an existing console application where I have added the Syncfusion PDF Library. If you want to know how to get started with the Syncfusion PDF library, refer to the video link in the card above. Now, I will show you how to add a text watermark to a PDF file using the Syncfusion PDF library. First, I add the necessary namespaces like Syncfusion PDF, Syncfusion PDF Parsing, and Syncfusion PDF Graphics to use the Syncfusion PDF library. Then, I define the text watermark PDF method with void type and add the code. Next, I retrieve the PDF file location and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Then, create an instance of the PDF loaded document class and initialize it with the file stream object. Get the first page of the loaded PDF document. And create graphics for the PDF page. Graphics represents the drawing surface or canvas for graphical elements like images, text, and shapes. Next, define a standard font with a name and size to display the text in a custom style. I will save the graphics state to modify the graphics context and later restore it to its original state. The transparency of the graphics context for the PDF page is set to 25%. And rotate the graphics context by minus 40 degrees. Negative values indicate a counterclockwise rotation. Finally, I use the drawstring method to set the watermark text on the PDF page. Following that, I create an output file stream. And save the output PDF document to the stream. Then, call the close method to clear the memory consumed by PDF DOM and its document stream. I will invoke the text watermark PDF method to generate a PDF document with a text watermark. Now, let me save and run the application. Looking here, when I open the output file, you can see the added text watermark. Next, let me show you how to add an image watermark to a PDF document. I define the image watermark PDF method with void type and comment on the existing code. I retrieve the image file location and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Then, create a PDF bitmap instance using the file stream object to read the image stream data. Finally, draw the image as the watermark on the PDF page using the drawImage method. Call the image watermark PDF method to generate the PDF with the image watermark. When I open the output file, you will see the image watermark added. Next, I will show you how to remove a watermark. First, I add the necessary namespace, Syncfusion PDF Interactive. Then, I define the remove watermark PDF method with void type. I modify the input document and comment on the existing code. Iterate through each page of the loaded PDF document and retrieve each page as a PDF loaded page object. Then, retrieve the collection of annotations present on that page. Annotations in a PDF document can include various elements like text, shapes, and, in this case, watermarks. Iterate through the annotation collection on the current page. And retrieve each annotation as a PDF loaded annotation object. Check whether the current annotation is not null, and whether it is of the type PDF loaded watermark annotation. If an annotation meets these criteria, remove the watermark annotation from the page's annotation collection using the removeAt method. Next, call the removeWatermarkPDF method to generate the PDF without watermark. I open the output file, and the PDF document will be displayed without watermark. Next, let me show you how to add bookmarks to an existing PDF document. I define a method called addBookmarksPDF with void type. I modify the input document and comment on the existing code. Next, create an instance of the PDF bookmark class using the add method. The destination property of the bookmark is set to specify the destination page when the bookmark is clicked. I set the text style of the parent bookmark to bold. And the bookmark's color to red. I set the location property of the bookmark's destination. Next, I add a child bookmark under the previously created parent bookmark. The insert method is used to specify the position of the child bookmark within the parent bookmark. Like the parent bookmark, the child bookmark's destination is set to a specific page and location. I call the addBookmarksPDF method to generate the PDF with added bookmarks. I open the output file, and you will see bookmarks added to the existing document. Next, I will show you how to insert bookmarks. I define the insert bookmarks method with void type. I modify the input document and comment on the existing code. Insert a new bookmark in the existing bookmark collection using the insert method of the PDF bookmark base class. Then, set the bookmark destination page and location using the PDF destination class. I set the text style of the bookmark to bold and the color to green. I call the insert bookmarks method to generate the document by inserting a bookmark. When I open the output file, you can see the inserted bookmark. Next, let me show you how to modify bookmarks in a PDF document. I define the modify bookmarks method with void type and comment on the existing code. It retrieves all the bookmarks using the PDF bookmark base class. Next, select the first bookmark in the collection. The destination property of the bookmark is set to specify the destination page when the bookmark is clicked. After that, I set the bookmark's color to green and text style to bold. Now, the title property of the bookmark is set to Chapter 2. I invoke the Modify Bookmarks method. In the output file, you can see the modified bookmark. Next, let me show you how to remove bookmarks from the PDF document. First, I define the Remove Bookmarks method with void type. I modify the input document. Then, I remove a bookmark from the document using the RemoveAt method. In this case, it removes the bookmark at index 1. I comment on the existing code. Finally, it removes a child bookmark named Section 4 from this parent bookmark. I call the Remove Bookmarks method. When I open the output file, you can see the removed bookmark. Let me recap what I have demonstrated so far. I showed you how to add text and image watermarks to a PDF using the Syncfusion PDF library. I also showed you how to remove a watermark and add, insert, modify, and remove bookmarks from a PDF document. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our .NET products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.